Hi, I'm Patricia Dunn-Fierstein, a licensed clinical social worker and certified Sandplay therapist teacher working in South Tampa for about 28 years now. I have a private practice in psychotherapy, working with children as young as two, teens, adults, couples, and families. Today I would like to introduce you to one type of therapy that I do, which is called Sandplay therapy. This is a form of therapy that was developed by a woman named Dora Kalff in Switzerland in the 1950s. She was a student of Carl Jung. So join me while we explore Sandplay therapy together. This is the Sandplay therapy room. It includes two trays of sand. One is wet and water is allowed to be added to that. The other stays dry. Both trays have blue on the bottom and the sides so that the sand can be pushed aside and one can create what might be a river or a lake or a pond. The sides can be like the sky. These trays hold the free and protected space that Frau Kalff so often spoke about, where a client can freely express what's going on within them in the safety of the tray in order to be able to process it and ultimately to heal it. As you can see, the shelves are full of miniatures of everything from the real and imaginary world. These are not just toys, but include images of people of all sorts, art, representation of artifacts from different cultures, religious symbols, things from the natural world, and many other items that are meant to touch our psyches and touch our hearts and help to symbolize material from the unconscious and conscious mind. You could think of Sandplay therapy as a form of three-dimensional art therapy, where clients move the sand if they wish to form a landscape of sorts, and select anything they choose from the shelves to create this three-dimensional image, often expressing things non-verbally that they are unable to verbalize. A story may be told while the play is going on, or after it's over. Sometimes clients will share their thoughts. But no matter how it's done, even if it's done in complete silence, a great deal is expressed. Of course, children go to this like a duck to water. They naturally work out their problems through play and express themselves in the language of play. And with this vast array of images to choose from, Sandplay provides children with an immense vocabulary to further their work, their processing, and their healing. When children use Sandplay therapy, it often takes most of the session. When adults and teens do it, it's usually just part of a session. And it provides clients with access to that right emotional brain, which especially as teens and adults, we get so cut off from in our left brain dominant world. It also provides access to the unconscious, much like dreams do when we sleep. But we know that healing is usually promoted when the unconscious is given a vehicle to safely express itself, which is what Sandplay therapy does so well. While you're finishing that up, what can you tell me about what you made there?
Well, it's an army about Civil War and other things. And over here, I'm talking about when it was over and all things were fine and stuff.
Oh, this is when it was peaceful.
Yeah, and this wasn't.
We'll call the little boy Michael that you just saw creating those two trays. And he really is at the end of his process after working through some traumatic things that happened to him in his life. And if you remember when he spoke about, even though he had created this tray on the right first, he spoke about the war tray really coming first. First there was the war, and then there was the peace. And if we look at this peace tray, we can see where he's come. We have traffic flowing. This gives a sense of energy within him, in motion. He's got horsepower. He can tap into his inner energizing resources. Very beautifully, he called this a bale of hay, which speaks to his ability to gather the resources from within himself and have really food, internal food that will feed him. And he even has a little tractor to be able to gather more. Also, classically, little boys and airplanes are very important. I don't want to leave girls out, but they are particularly important for boys, the ability to take off into the world. And this one is even able to land in water, which speaks to the unconscious. The feelings that once overwhelmed him, he can now even take off and land from. And this bridge so beautifully depicts the things that he has crossed over. And he has a wonderful celebratory marching band, really speaking to his own celebration of the work that he has done in the sand tray. I thank you for your interest in Sandplay therapy today. And if you have any further questions or you want to seek Sandplay therapy services or training, feel free to contact me or any of the affiliated organizations listed at the end of this video. Thank you very much for your time.